Very good morning to you all. We'll move on to the topic today, the rubber-lined butterfly valves. As you hear the name, rubber lining, that tells that there is a seating material in the form of an elastomer that becomes a soft seat. I have also put the picture of a butterfly. When you continuously open and close the valve, that will resemble the action of a butterfly. That's one of the reasons the name butterfly valve has come into prominence. What is a butterfly valve? The valves are categorized into multi-turn and quarter turn. It means when you want to open or close the valve, you need to rotate many turns, that is a multi-turn, and you have to operate 1/4 of a circle. So which means 360 degrees, one circle, and 1/4 is a 90 degree opening or closing, that's a quarter turn. And it has a concentric and eccentric design. It is soft seated, as we saw the name rubber line, and it is useful for on off and regulating. It means for full isolation and also for throttling applications. It is very light in weight, and with respect to the construction as compared to gate valve, this is light in weight and there is no headroom, and it is very compact face to face as compared to gate valve. And the end connections are wafer type and wafer lugged. As you all are aware, wafer is flangeless, which means there is no integral flange attached to it. And wafer lugged is another construction. It has a semi-flange. The number of holes which are required for a flange will be available. But in order to have a weight reduction and in order to reduce the weight in the sagging in the pipeline, the portion between the holes which are optimized. So let us quickly see the classification of valves and where does butterfly valve stand. Considering the function, that is isolation, regulation, non-return valve, safety control, this comes under regulation because it can do both isolation and also regulation. With respect to the operation, which is multi-turn, quarter turn, and self-actuated, this comes under the category of quarter turn. And coming to the seating, there are valves where you can give extra torque to make the seal effective. So they are called torque seated valve. Butterfly valves and bolted bonnet design gate valve with the flex wedge design also falls under that category. Let us look at the types of butterfly valves. Concentric design, single offset, double offset, and triple offset. What is concentric design? When you look at from the top view, so you are seeing the body on both sides, and you are seeing the disc in light blue color, and you are seeing the dark blue color shaft or stem, which is positioned at the center of the disc and also at the center line of the body axis. So body seat and disc are on the same plane. So that's why it's called concentric or zero offset valve. What is the advantage of this concentric design? Especially when you are using for a soft seated valve, as the interference is good, the sealing is more effective. There is always a trade-off between the interference and the effective sealing requirements. So when you are using a concentric design and the valve body has a rubber lining, the metal component disc which rotates and has an interference to have the sealing. It is used in low operating pressure and especially low temperature areas. We will go through what is the temperature limitation and what is the maximum temperature withstanding for each one of the liners as we go along. And it gives zero leakage because any soft seated valve will give zero leakage, which means 100% bubble tight sealing, or you call it as a tight shutoff type. And the torque is relatively less as compared to metal seated valves. to have another difference between a concentric design and an eccentric design. An eccentric design is nothing but a design which has an offset. A concentric design, we have seen the seat, that is the disc seat, and also the shaft on the center line, which is on the same plane as the body seat center line. And whereas when it comes to the eccentric design, you are seeing the center of the rotation of the shaft, which is having an offset from the disc center. And similarly, that is the first offset. And the second offset is the center of the rotation of the shaft is also having an offset from the center line of the body. So which means there is a first and second offset. So why does this kind of offset require? Though we say the interference is good for effective sealing, but when you have a metal seat, the interference will have a problem. The interference will not allow you to seal because the torque requirements will be very high. So to reduce the torque and reduce the interference, there is an offset which are created. So today we will restrict our discussion with concentric design and rubber line butterfly valves. The typical range could be, as we talked about, low pressure, that is PN10, then PN16, class 150, and PN25. The designs are, what you are seeing in the first picture is a wafer design. You are not seeing any flange attached to it. This valve will go in between the pipe flanges in the line. The advantage is that you can easily position this with the help of a lifting hole, which is given here, and the valve should be kept in close position before you install. And instead of having a double bolting on a normal flange valve, this requires only a single bolting that is sufficient, and a long stud and nut which is sufficient. And this is the double flanged design. And here what I mentioned as a lug design, the entire holes will be there, but this material between the holes will not be there. That's a unique design in order to reduce the weight. The wafer lug design was developed. Here you can see a complete picture. This is a wafer that is a flangeless design. And the second one is the wafer lug. See, the number of holes will be the same as the double flange valve, but the material between the holes will be reduced to optimize the weight. So the self-aligning of this is possible in wafer lugged and double flange, whereas the self-aligning with the pipeline flange is not possible in wafer flangeless design. The typical size range which is being followed by the manufacturers are wafer type up to 24 inch, including 2.5 inch, then wafer lugged also 2 inch to 24 inch, and flange you can go for higher sizes, generally about 6 inch to 36 inch. This is on the concentric design. But if you are going for an offset, single offset or a double offset design, there is a possibility to go for much higher sizes, even up to 120 inch. So that is also possible. So close to about 3000 mm valves are also designed in single and double offset design. The PN25 category, which is a higher pressure, that is also available in wafer designs by many manufacturers. The compliance of standards which is being followed, there is a European norms standard, the popular standard EN593, which was coinciding with British standard 5155, then the API standard 609 category A, then manufacturer standard MSSSP 67, and metal valves category ISO 5752. The pressure testing is used with the standard of EN12266 and API 598. The end connections, we have wafer connection and followed by the flange as per BS table D of BS 10 standard and E, and ASME B 16.1 class 125, and the flange dimensions will be B16.5 of class 150. The pressure rating, generally the testing for butterfly valves as like any other valve. So the shell test, that is the body capability, that is tested with the shell test of 1.5 times of the rated pressure. So for a PN10 valve, the shell test pressure is done at 15 bar and the seat is done at 1.1 times, that is at 11 bar. Similarly, for PN16 valves, the rated working pressure of 16 bar, the shell test is done at 24 bar, 1.5 times, and the seat test is done at 1.1 times of 17.6 bar. Similarly, class 150, the rated working pressure is close to 20, that is 19.2 bar precisely. Shell test is done at 30 bar and seat test is done at 22 bar. The commonly used material of construction, less than class 150 up to class 125, the standard permits use of cast iron as a body material. So that is why you will still find cast iron is a body material in butterfly valves very prominently. PN10, which can be made in cast iron, then PN16 can also be made because it is equivalent to class 125. And class 150 is an overlapping pressure rating where you can use SG iron body and carbon steel. Of course, all the pressure rating, if a customer or somebody desires to have a carbon steel body, that is possible even in PN10. The disc material is also similarly follow the same pattern, cast iron, SG iron, then stainless steel disc. Unlike any other valve, butterfly valve has the closure member, that is the disc, which is always exposed to the line fluid. So there is a necessity for having a corrosion protection of the closure member, that is the disc. Even if it is used a cast iron, it is advisable not to have a bare cast iron because this will very easily get corroded and goes off in service. So there is necessary corrosion protection coating, which I will explain to you. We use a nylon coating, there is an encapsulation which is done on a cast iron and SG iron. And of course, a bare disc is used if it is a stainless steel disc. And the shaft is nothing but the stem, which is of low carbon steel, then martensitic stainless steel SS410. And any other the stem material which is having a good torque resistance, they will be able to use. And the liner is one which is very, very important, that gives the butterfly valves the zero leakage. So the soft material, that is in the form of an elastomer, it could be a low acrylic nitrile or a high acrylic nitrile or EPDM. And there are many other liners can also be used, like silicon rubber for higher temperature and for chemical services, Hypalon or Veton. So butterfly valve is always called as a fit and forget valve. Why so? Because the entire body, the disc, bare material do not get exposed to the line fluid. Because either you have a coating on the disc like nylon or it is stainless steel. And when you talk about the body, which is lined with the elastomer, so the entire the contact point do not get exposed to the line fluid directly. The other options I have explained, Veton, Hypalon, silicon, and the disc also, the variance is possible. Aluminium bronze when it comes for seawater applications, very prominently used. And some of the concentric designs, you will have ebonite lining, which is very good for seawater applications. The salient features, when you look at the construction, will be, now the valve is in open condition, so the disc is fully exposed to the line fluid, and you have a top shaft, that is a top stem and the bottom shaft, and there is a anti-blowout screw like any other. This is also anti-blowout stem. The stem will never come out of the body. The anti-double pin, which goes inside the slot, which is provided on the top shaft, so that it doesn't allow to go out of the body. And the body has a ISO mounting for direct fitment of actuators and gear units. The acetal bush, which is used, which is a low coefficient of friction material to reduce the friction between the two mating components, that is the body and the stem. is another view, the components which are taken out. So this is the disc, this is the body which is rubber lined, or the soft seated are also called a resilient seat, which means it is a soft seat which has the flexibility as a character. When there is a interference, it will get compressed, then it will regain its original position when the valve gets opened. This is a double flange construction, the same body with a double flange, and body has a lining of the elastomer material. A very interesting thing, the success of the rubber lining is how the rubber lining is done on the body. It depends on that logic. There is a technology called transfer molding, which is nothing but integrally molding the liner with the body. So the advantage is there are additives like plasticizers, which can be added to the elastomer when you are following a transfer molding technology, that helps to give you the rigidity which is required, and at the same time, the flexibility. The flexibility is what it is very important, because this technology, when you are using, there is an interference which I have mentioned to you. So there is a need for having the elastomer get compressed and regain its original position when it is, when the load is released. So there is a need for having a good flexibility. At the same time, the rigidity will help you to have other wear and tear resistance. And one interesting thing is when you are seeing, so this is the rubber lining, what you are seeing in the black color, and this is the body. So this will come and seat on the entire body. And when you are installing this in the pipeline, there is no need for additional gasket. This liner itself will act as a built-in flange gasket. This is the advantage of integrally molded liner. Of course, the standard do permit to use a loose liners also, but the loose liners have disadvantage of any air packets which is left between the lining and the body. So that will result in the starting of corrosion later in service. Maybe immediately it may not be having a problem, but after few days of service, the possibilities of these air packets will become the potential path for corrosion to start. The stem, which is designed in such a way with the square on the top, that will give you a very positive engagement, positive shaft disk drive, and entirely corrosion prevention with the help of a coating on the shaft. Even though there is a carbon steel, there is a 410 martensitic stainless steel shaft which is used in order to have low coefficient of friction. There is a PTFE based coating which is done on that, which means which is having a coating kind of xylon or PTFE base that will give you a lower friction. It will act as a low coefficient of friction material and prevent any jamming or any micro weld which happens because of the heat. When you continuously rotate, there is a need for having one material to have a low coefficient of friction. And as I explained to you, the anti-blowout stem, you are seeing a slot on the shaft. So when there is a double pin which is inserted from the body that will come and sit here, will not allow the shaft to go up in terms of any pressure getting built up inside the pipeline. So the outcome is very ease of operation and dependability. So would you agree that now it's kind of a fit and forget valve? The disc, as I said, continuously exposed to the line fluid. So there is a need for giving a sufficient protection for the disc. Either it could be a stainless steel disc, so there is no protection required, because stainless steel inherently has a chromium oxide passive layer on the surface that will act as a corrosion resistant material. But when you are using a carbon steel disc or a SGIN disc, there is a need for a protection that is done with the help of a nylon. It is not just a paint. We do encapsulation. It's a coating. There is a process. There is a cleaning by way of a grid blasting, then followed by there is a high temperature. The coating is, it's done in a dipped condition. So with that, what will happen is the thickness can be built much higher. The nylon thickness on this coating is about 300 to 400 microns. So that will help you to have a good corrosion protection and a good finished surface to have a lower torque, and it is encapsulated, it is not just painted, because the painting you cannot build higher thickness. The outcome of this is to have a longer life. The operators, as we all seen, a basic is a lever, flow control lever. So you can press the lever and you can rotate, and the gear unit which can be used normally about 12 inch sizes, gear units are preferred, because the standard says 350 Newton meter and above, there is a need for a gear unit. And lower size also, if the frequency is very high, one can opt for gear unit, even for the smaller sizes of 4 inch or 6 inch or 8 inch. But otherwise, in general, about 12 inch will have a gear unit. And like any other valve, this valve can also be actuated both electrically and with pneumatic. It's a rack and pinion or a Scotch yoke type of pneumatic actuators, which can directly be fitted on the ISO 5211 platform, which is provided on the body. We'll spend little time on the type of liners, because this is very important for selection of the right type of valve with the liner. As I explained, the low acrylic nitrile is the basic elastomer which is used in butterfly valve, especially on the lined butterfly valves. It has a service temperature capability of minus 45 degree to 70 degree Celsius. Very good for applications like drinking water, chilled water, and HVAC applications. The next comes, there is a higher grade of nitrile, that is N5 or high nitrile. Their capability of temperature resistance is much higher, from minus 28 degree Celsius to 120 degree Celsius. So one can think of using on seawater, mineral oil, fuels, slurries, lime, and mild acids and bases. As I said, though for utilities, it is a good product, there are mild acids and bases of chemicals, this can be used. The next, a good elastomer is EPDM, which also has about 120 degrees Celsius temperature capability resistance. Then it can be used for potable water, hot water, HVAC, powders, and chemical services. Viton and Hypalon, these two are generally used for chemical services. Viton has about 150 degrees Celsius maximum temperature resistance, and it can be used for acids, solvents, aromatic fuels, and some of the hydrocarbons and fly ashes. Hypalon is another elastomer which is used for chemical applications. Acids with high temperature, bases, sulfuric acid, high concentration with lower temperature. Okay, because the temperature maximum resistance is 70 degrees Celsius for Hypalon. Silicon rubber is one which is used for a very high temperature as far as the butterfly valves are concerned. Of course, there is a polymer lined valves in double offset and other designs. There it can withstand even a little higher temperature, but on an elastomer, about 180 degrees Celsius temperature resistance is available for silicon rubber, that's used for hot air applications in many process industries. Butterfly valves are also treated with CE marking and ATEX marking in order to have a resistance to work in explosive prone services, and also for some of the atmospheric temperature or the atmospheric service which calls for specific amount of corrosion resistance, and this gets qualified. So the CE marking that enables to ascertain this quality requirement and also to supply for European region. And ATEX marking is also available for any other valve like gate lobe check and butterfly valves. In addition to the standard tests as a production test, like hydrostatic shell test and hydrostatic seat test, there are other tests with respect to the elastomers which are very, very important. Spark test, which is also called as holiday test, which ensures there is no inconsistency in the elastomer, like pinholes or discontinuities or any voids, which is covering the metallic surface. If they are all there in service, there is a possibility, then the corrosion may start and the fluid can get exposed to the body material. The moment the body material gets exposed to this kind of a fluid, there is a wear and tear and the body will get damaged. Similarly, the bond strength of the rubber lining with the body. So there is a adhesion test, which is also performed. Then there is a tensile and compression set test, which is done on elastomer material. I explained to you, because the lining where the interference is there, definitely there should be a good amount of flexibility, which means it should come back to its original position when the load is released. So this is also tested, tension and compression set type test. And some of the cases, even the production test, when we want to do for some specific applications, critical applications, this is possible. Then the specific gravity test, it is to measure the physical properties to ensure elongation and flexibility against cracking. And abrasion test, elastomers are known for abrasion resistant material. So there is a load which is given with the help of an indentation, and that will measure and tell you what is the level of hardness, because they're all measured in shore hardness. So that will tell you what is the level of hardness to against, there will be a abrasion resistance, which you will get for, especially when you use for some slurry applications, this abrasion test, the results are very important. As I started with the valve selection, which is very, very important when you talk about selecting the right valve with right material of construction, and more importantly, the lining materials. So first we need to know the operating pressure and the design pressure, the line fluid, the service temperature, because different elastomers have different temperature resistance capability. Then the pH value, the corrosion of the material which is used, whether it is less than 7 or it is 7 or it is above 7, and the particle size and with velocity. What is the particle size, whether it is very minute or less than 50 microns or less than 10 microns or above 10 microns. So these are all very important. And current trim materials like the shaft or the disc, this forms the trim material over and above the lining. So the selection of the valve is highly dependent on this information, which is furnished to a manufacturer or the application engineer to select the right product. So we are coming to the end of the presentation. L&T Valves has a very comprehensive product range. The multi-turn category of gate, globe and check valves, then ball valves including trunnion mounted and floating ball valve, top entry and side entry. The butterfly valves, a portion of that we have seen today, that is a rubber line soft seated. In addition to that, there is a double offset and triple offset butterfly valves. Then there is a plug valve, which is a double block and bleed plug valve and sleeve plug valve. And the host of control valves, starting from globe, butterfly, ball and plug. And of course, special valves for marine applications with bronze and nickel aluminium bronze, and choke valves for upstream applications. Then high integrity pressure protection system as a part of the valve automation, which will replace the multiple safety release valves in a plant or in a loop. And like smartwatch, smartphone, there is a smart valve which will be able to predict the failure which is ahead of the time, so that the necessary maintenance can be scheduled and the replacements can be thought of.